We have a very big question in front of us. Who is a DBA? What does DBA do? Before I take you into the Oracle Database admin roles and responsibilities, let us understand who is an admin in general terms. As per online dictionary, administration is different activities involved in managing or organizing a business. In other words, administration involves managing things in a way which keeps business running smoothly, like the administrative work of a department or a company. An admin worker who takes care of managing and keeping office space, stationery and other things aligned or maybe clean or maybe managing all those kind of stuff. Of course, as a database admin, we won't have to do all this. So the same way, a database administrator is a person who is responsible to execute different set of activities which help in managing a database. A DBA is actually responsible to maintain a smooth running database environment. They make sure that data is available to users and is secure from unauthorized access. Now here I will give you some responsibilities of an database administrator, like identifying user needs to create and administer databases, ensuring that the database operates efficiently and without any error, making and testing modifications to the database structure when needed, maintaining the database and updating permissions, merging old databases into new ones, backing up and restoring data to prevent data loss. Now the list is not limited. I just gave you an overview of the DBA responsibilities. Now, many database administrators are general purpose DBAs and have all the duties, like all the above duties which I just talked. However, some DBAs specialize in certain tasks that vary with the organization and its needs. So there is nothing like a fixed DBA or fixed roles and responsibilities that you will be working on. Because technology is always evolving, nowadays the organizations have a differentiated database administration roles. There are basically four. I'll talk about all the four DBA roles. The first one is administrative DBA. So this guy maintains the servers and databases and keeps them running. So concerned with backups, security, patches, replication, and other such tasks. Now, the next one is development DBA. So this guy works on building SQL queries, stored procedures, and so on that meets business needs. This is the equivalent of a programmer actually, but specializing in database development. So it is not like application development, it is development inside the database by writing SQL queries and stored procedures, functions, and triggers. So commonly combined the role of administrative DBA. So the development DBA is kind of a guy who also might know the details or the roles and responsibilities of administrative DBA. Next is a data architect. This role works to build a structure or design that meets a general business needs in a particular area. The design is then used by developers and development DBAs to implement the actual application. For example, some client needs to develop a complete new application. So the data architect guy, he will sit with the client and design the entire database on papers, and then it will be passed on to the development DBA and administrative DBAs to create the database and create the application logic. And the last type of DBA role that we are seeing nowadays is data warehouse DBA. So this is a new role that is coming up. It is responsible for merging data from multiple sources into a big database. So let's take your company is having 150 databases and they want to consolidate all those 150 into one big database. So this kind of database which stores data from multiple databases is called a data warehouse. It's like it will have all the data, right? Kind of a warehouse. So the DBA who manages this kind of database is comes under this category, like data warehouse DBA. So this is, like as I mentioned, it's a relatively new role responsible for merging data from multiple sources into a data warehouse. So may have to design the data warehouse as well as cleaning up and standardizing the data before loading using like specialist data loading and transformational tools. So I think you don't have to worry about those kind of details as of now, but just understand this is also a new role, like data warehouse DBA. So you might be thinking, like, which DBA you should become and what type of DBA role we will be learning about in this course. So in this course, I am focusing more on how to become an administrative DBA, because it's very easy to start and later you can move into becoming a development DBA or a database architect or maybe a data warehouse DBA. If you are good at administrative DBA, then you can definitely change your role in future into the other DBA segments. Maybe you want to become a development DBA, you can move to development DBA. You want to become a database architect, you can become a database architect. And if you want to move to a data warehouse DBA, you can definitely move in. In the upcoming lessons, you will understand more in detail about the Oracle DBA roles and responsibilities. Keep learning.